Excuse me, are my radishes done? Hey, what's up, guys and gals? My name is Rick9G. Again, thank you for joining me and supporting the series. Of course, my channel, but of course, also the series Banished. We're playing Colonial Charter. Basically, the modded, one of the modded versions, which have tons and tons of mods, as you can see. Look at this, I just click and click and click, and so many options, and your head hurts because there's so many options. But I'm having so much fun. Yes, I'm having so much fun, guys and gals, playing this game. Alright, let's get right into it. We have a little bit of work to do, of course. Well, we always have work to do. But we gotta make sure our people are being taken care of and are super, super, super healthy. Alright, so let's accelerate time. We see some peeps over here. What I wanna do, though, is make a little bit of a bridge. Now I'm thinking somewhere down in this area. We already have some buildings here, and I think something that will come straight this direction would be awesome for us. So let's do that. Let's start with a little bit of a bridge. We don't have that much stone. That's the problem. But we'll figure it out. We'll get it done. Now, how much is that? That's 52 wood, 13 stone. Okay. We'll just do it. And then this will combine to there. Hopefully that'll work. I just want to get some people to maybe do some logging over here and just some work that we need to get done. So let's recoup some of these resources. We definitely need the stone, like I was saying, so that'll definitely work. We have four laborers. Let's see, three builders, three farmers. I want to get another farm going, believe it or not. I know I have tons of farms, but I think it would be great. I think it would be great for just the food value and production. Of course, this gatherer's hut is going to be moving. Yes, over here. So maybe when that's done, we'll close this down and we'll get this going. We have three people here, so we'll just move them back over here. And what barn will they come to? Well, we might have to build another barn. We'll see, guys and gals. We definitely don't want them to go nuts. Let's actually get that moving. Let's get that going. Let's slow down time just a little bit. Now, we could get a lot of barns, meaning there's different choices. This is huge, not great. We want something a little more manageable. Now, these, I think they're a little too small. I definitely like this small one, 30 and 8. I mean, this is great for what we're getting. So, let's just use it. I think we'll put it midway, somewhere in there. And again, we'll plunk it down. I think it'll be really good, really helpful for us. We have all of these great farms. We have a little stockpile going on here. And what do we have low? Stone. Yes, I know we have low stone production, but look at this. We have reached our peak, or we've reached our value here with the tools. Let's stay there for a little bit. We'll keep them at 80. We'll keep the blacksmith busy, basically, which means if any run out, so let's say someone breaks a tool, they'll come and grab it, and if it gets below that 80 number, the blacksmith will replenish that, so we'll keep it at 80. Now let's look at the lumber. Now you see 400. There's no separate measure for lumber. It just says this material should be 400, so we're going to keep going. We're going to keep this to 500. Actually, let me do 450. So it won't use up all our wood. We're going to definitely make sure a lot of that wood is used. Oh, and we have our first trader. Hello, buddy. What's your name? I have no idea. Oh, please are the rancher. Oh, so he's selling bison. Bison, I think, could be meat. Now, here's the problem. Each bison costs 800 units or 800. Yeah. Basically, they need 800 units, and so you have your valley over here. So we have 100 fish at one valley. That's 100 units, 200 units, and 20 rough tools multiplied by 2 is 40. So we have 240, not nearly enough for bison. So he'll stay here for a little bit, and he'll leave. So I think now we'll just dismiss him. We're not there yet, guys and gals. We're not there to the point where we can have just a good trade. So we're going to wait. We're going to wait on that. And that'll be fine, no problemo. Alright, so the radishes seem to be doing pretty... Oh, these are peppas. Peppas! As Coily says from the Three Stooges. Yeah. Alright, so this is good because they are already harvesting the peppers, and that's great. Now this, oh yeah, the radishes are already being harvested. I'm going to do another field over here. Like I said, I want to make sure that we don't run out of food anytime soon. But I am going to add something else. Oh, I already did the apiary. We're really waiting for the apiary. I'm so excited. This is going to be the episode of the apiary. Let me just get a nice little shot of this. Let's look at this. Oh, there we go. There's the apiary. Yay! The apiary. So, in case you don't know, the apiary is a place where you have tons of hives and therefore bees. Let's add a worker there. Yes, we still have enough. Good. 4. And this is going to make us 2 things. We're going to get honey, which is, of course, food. It'll be brought right into the storage facility and kept there. And people will eat, of course. They will get their good amount of, what, sweets, and they'll make things with the honey. But also beeswax, which they can't eat, but we can use that later on to produce different things. So that's definitely something we're going to keep an eye on. Let's add another house. Now, can we add 2? If we add 1 here, we can add 2. So it's a lot of homes. I definitely know that. That's 32 wood and 16 stone. We're low on the stone, although my peeps should be gathering it, and I think they have, and that's how they've been making this bridge. And let's get right to this. Let's get right to this field that we were going to do. Let me just plug in a nice little road for now. And we're going to place another. I think we're going to do peppers again. I don't want to make it too big, the reason being we only want 1 person to take care of it. I think that's good. And hopefully that'll be very helpful to us. It'll get, of course, more food into our population. 744 radishes. I have a good amount of food. I'm going to bring 200 more radishes over here. Hopefully that won't really damage the amount of food here. So let's go to radishes again. I'm going to teach you something about this. 200 more, so that's up to 300. They're going to bring the 200 extra. Now, let me tell you something. If you happen to trade, let's say, these 300 radishes, okay, keep that in mind. So this will go down to 0. Your count will go down to 0. But the desired will stay, and they will keep bringing the same amount. So that might take a lot of the storage materials back into the traders, and they won't have it for food. So be careful, and that'll work for anything. So be very careful about that. Make sure to reset those numbers after you trade. And I'll show you that in the future, but just so you know. All right, let's go to the honey farm. I think this is a nice screenshot right here. Look at that, that is awesome. So you have the honey down here. Now let's look and see what they're producing. Look at that already, 54 honey and 18 beeswax. I'm sure the honey is where? Beeswax is over here. They've already eaten all the honey. Wow, they're really excited about that. Oh, 6, let me add 1 more. Can I add another one? For some reason I can't. So I'm gonna just leave it at 1 for now. And let me just lower the speed or make it a little slower here. And of course I am going to, boom, make those a top priority. This is ready and we're gonna do peppers. And we're gonna add a 4th and a 5th. So this apparently needs 2. This needs 1 and probably 2 for this. Oh no, 1, okay. Perfect. No problemo there. There we go. And so, of course, we would love to have better things. Not that radishes and peppers aren't great, but I mean, how filling would be if you had just a radish and pepper salad? Not so great. But then we have honey. So slowly, as you can see, we're adding. Let's continue with the production here. We're not going to reduce any of the tree pop. We're going to just reduce a lot of this stuff. Gatherer's hut is here. We have 3 over here. And now we're going to destroy this. I know it's bittersweet. It was our first gatherer's hut, but for right now, we don't need it. I know some of you may say, no, Rick, keep it because it might make you double the food. I'm going to need the space for another field. Even the storage container. Well, I might leave this and just make this the field here. I'm going to have to plow through all of this because I want to move this way. We already have our graveyard. No one has died. 32 graves. Dun, 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 dun. All right, everything looks fantabulous. Look at this. That one's gonna be demolished soon. And let's just fast forward, guys and gals. Yeah. How are fish docks doing? Oh yeah, pretty good. All right, so right now we're getting logs for some reason, 300 or so, and it's not a huge distance. So they walk from here, cut corners, and they bring the fish here. Frish, yeah, the frish. Tools are doing okay, very good. We are stockpiling the stone. The lumber is still being made. Let's see how much lumber we have. 44. Okay, that'll be very necessary. Let's continue with the food. We definitely want to make sure we can increase our food production. Now, something I really like, see if I can find it. Here it is. Tidal pool. You may say, what in the world is a tidal pool? Well, I might place one. Where do I want to place it? That is the key. Now, I think this might be a nice area. Let me place it right here. So it needs lumber, stone, which we have, and some logs. Basically, this is going to collect a lot of stuff. We're going to be able to get things like clams and some of the seafood, like, I don't think lobster. But I think something very similar to that. I'm going to have to check again. Let me see. Does it tell me? Yeah, oysters, mussels, crayfish, and seaweed. So these are all kind of fishy populate, other than fish. So it's not, they're just not going to eat minnows and so forth. This will be really, really good food for these guys. And let's see, we have gather set, we have fish. Hunting cabin might be good, but I don't think now is the proper time. So let me get this going. Let me do a little bit of harvesting. We're gonna harvest this whole area. We're gonna get it really, really nice and bare. Let's take a bird's eye view in our helicopter. Great, we are done with the, not shore house, tidal pool, there we go. So we're gonna add, we can add one or more. Let's see what we have. We could add two. It's just extra food, guys and gals, and we kind of need it. Our food is going to increase. Why don't we just add another one? I'm going to add, there we go, and we'll have two of two. This is a unique person. What are they called? They're not called shoremen. Dredger. There we go. So the dredger, two that are working there. Very nice. And we still have a couple extra to do other tasks. Now, the lumber hit its limit. So let's increase that to 500. You see how lumber is in the material section, but there's other stuff in the material section too. So we need more lumber, so we gotta increase that just a little bit. Let's take a look at our homes. Remember, we do our little census count, my own little census count. We have a guy and a girl, husband and wife here. Very good, pretty young, no babies, husband and wife. Look there, one baby. Look at this, two kids, and look, this laborer can even move out. Isn't that crazy how already, now these are middle-aged already. Wow, in their 40s. That is, they're probably one of the first settlers here. All right, and good. So you can see that I can definitely add another home. Question is where? The question is exactly what do I want to do? But let's look at this. I don't know if you guys knew this. I know some of you do. Paths, and so this shows me what's everyone's path. So if I click here, this tells me that the workers here, okay, so one worker lives here, one lives here, this is their path to work. And you ideally want their path to be very short. So if you can even get a home like right here, that would benefit you. They will actually move in here, and then two other people move in here. It restructures everything, it makes it more efficient. If they get cold, they can go back home and kind of recharge very quickly. So it's actually a really smart thing. Look at this. Yeah, our little bridge is done. So we're gonna put our little stockpile. We have one here. So maybe we don't need another one. Let's do this. Let's just do that little weird shape. Where Forester Lodge going out over here. How much are we getting? Not too many logs, just 24. All right, let me see if I can get some of these resources eaten up. There we go. Work hard on those resources, guys. Very nice. And that'll be an easy way. We might even make a little bridge later. But for now, this is good. This is more than adequate. That's what we want to happen. Look at this. Look at our little little community. Isn't this nice? Isn't this a nice community? Oh, it's fantastic. Even this storage might be nicely placed somewhere else. Ideally, probably moved on the outskirts here. Actually, probably over here, to tell you the truth. And we have enough logs, so I'm gonna do that. Why you think, I know some of you are thinking, Rick, why are you moving so much? Why are you moving everything? Well, because we're trying to expand, we're trying to maybe make another little farm here to increase our food supply. And it's a smart thing to do to kind of restructure things. So we're gonna have to do this. I'll show you what this is, and this is leveling out. So let's level this out. And that's how you do it. After that, you can remove that, and there you go. You've permanently labeled. You can't undo that, which is a little unfortunate, but it's better than nothing. So that should work. And nope. So they want that one leveled. We can definitely do that. I think that's what it wanted, right? No, not that one. This one. Okay. Very good. Now we'll place the barn. There we go. 48. 16. Boom. Alright, so we'll get that going. We'll get that being built, and we'll get another little field over here. Like I said, we want to increase the food so that we can get... Basically, we're trying to get currency or units, and those units will be traded for other crops that'll get us money. Well, not money, more units. And that'll help us expand what we're doing. So we're just trying to be hustlers here, guys and gals. True, honest to goodness hustlers. Alright, let's go back to the paths here. Let's take a look at a few more of these paths. Hopefully they're not too bad. Take a look. See, that's close. We like these. That's a little far. Not too bad. Oh, wow. These are good. See, now that's not ideal. Look at this. This person has to go really far. So sometimes it's good to put homes closer to that spot. Now this, we have a lot of stone, a lot of iron. I'm just going to queue this up. When they get the inkling or opportunity, they should do that. And look, we're getting tons and tons of herbs and spices and good stuff. All being put into here. That's exactly what we want. Very good, 152 logs that season. Very nice, they're being put in here. We have more lumber over here. And lots of iron ore, definitely lots of iron ore. I think we don't really need much iron ore. We need much more stone. That's the main thing we need. And then we'll transfer everything from here to here. Stone. Mr. Stone. Alright, let's cue it a little forward there. Now we're at really, really quick speed here, guys and gals. Our time is kind of coming to a close, little by little. I did want to see if I can add a few more things. Now, I think with food, we're kind of okay. There's so much stuff that you can do. There's refining of food, so windmills, oil presses, if you have things like orchards and so forth. Oh, let's see if I can do this. Hold on. There's even some... Let me see if I can make an orchard. That might actually be really nice, like a little orchard here. Okay, let me see. Problem is, I don't know where the options. There we go. So now... Here's what we're going to do. We're going to have this removed. And of course they will knock down the building. We'll be able to do what we got to do here. There we go. Food reserve is low. Oh, yes it is. Oh, baby it is. That's okay. Look at this, 90%. We'll get all of this harvested. And these guys are still working really hard, the dredgers. Look at that. Wow, this is all good stuff. Alright, let's continue. Let's see if we can get an orchard. We're going to do a dense orchard. Put that right over here. Not a huge one. Now, orchards take time. That's the only bad thing about them. They take, I think, the first year, you get no fruit. The trees just grow. And then the year after that, you actually get something. You get something you can harvest. So it's something to think about. Kind of a long-term investment, but then every year you get so much of those units. It's really, really helpful and really, really cool. Is that a duck? Oh my goodness, these ducks are always dangerous. But look at this, they're getting all these things, harvesting them, putting them in the right spot. That's exactly how I want to see it. Now let's look at the path. Remember I was showing you guys and gals? Look at that. See? Now one of the workers from the dock work lives here. And see, so that changes the whole dynamic. Look at this. They're collecting all this food. This is fantastic. Now they're putting it all over here. Look at this pepper. 700 peppers in here. So let's get... Oh, there we go. We have a trader. So let's slow down some time. Let's look at what the trader's bringing. So more bison. Wow. Can you bring anything else? Come on. All right. Well, we don't have enough. Well, we do, but we don't want to get rid of all of our food. So we're going to dismiss them. Maybe get... We have 900. We're going to get 200 more peppers or however peppers we have. Yeah, we're just going to do 200 there. And what will we have? 6, so 640. Wow, almost 700. Okay, and that's how you increase your units. You trade that in for something else. Maybe a seed or maybe bison, which could be food, animals. They reproduce and then they make what you gotta make. They make food for you. And then if you get cows, of course, they make milk and so forth. And you just keep on moving down the list. Now, our honey production is doing really well. Look at this season, current season, 243. Some seasons, they do a lot better once they're acclimated. So that's very, very good to keep track of. All right, look at that. Now, hopefully, they have a high priority here. We want them to get this orchard going. So I put high priority there. Look, and they're still harvesting. Now the problem is, again, this food is not really nutritious, so they might go through it really, really quickly. Really, really quickly. And for goodness sakes, why not add? Well, this is pretty good. It's not full or anything, so that should be fine. Thinking about homes in the future. Homes. I might add one more over here, which I'm gonna do. I don't mind cramming them that much, to be honest. I might do like another little row here and then add a little road. So we'll see. We'll see. Now this, we can make it a 550. There we go. All right, and my timer is just about to hit. I hope you guys and gals are doing awesome like I always wish you a fantabulous day, night, however and whenever you are watching. Hello from everyone to everyone in the United States and wherever you may be. I do appreciate you watching and I do hope that you're liking the series. If you do, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. It does let me know that you like it and it does help out my channel. I'm going to see you guys and gals next time. I'm going to leave the colonialists doing their work, working really hard. Look at this. Woo-wee. 111 this year. That's great and fantastic. All right, guys and gals, we'll see you all next time. And don't forget, be hopeful.